Hi everyone, how are you guys doing? Well, finally meeting you all after a long time. I am sorry since I could not reply to most of your messages and texts, but then I am back and I have been going through your text and I have been going through your messages also. And yes, a lot of people had inquired about me. Where am I lost? Am I well? Am I into corona? So there are a lot of people who have inquired about me, and I'm happy. Actually, I'm very much touched, seeing your feelings. And definitely, I would like to say, yes, I had some problem. I had some ailments, not because of corona. I had some skin infection. So I was under medication. I was not in a very good mood at that point of time, and I was also under some kind of professional commitments. So the best thing is that I am back, and I'm very happy to have you here. And I was thinking of making a video on some topic, then I came across so many of your messages that a lot of people want video on relationships. A lot of people want a lot of suggestions on relationships. Be on Insta, they have DM'd on my Insta, they have also texted on YouTube. So I'm very much thrilled to make a talk, a video on relationships. Yes, well, some people have actually also asked me, am I scared, or am I fearful to make a career on relationships? Why am I actually shying away from about talking about relationships? Well, I let me to clarify you that when it comes to romance, when it comes to relationships, I can go on and on, and there would be no time limit for this. So I can go on and on, and so because this is my favorite topic. And so today I'm going to take a dig on today's relationships, modern day relationships. Now, this topic is going to be, I would be as candid as possible, as honest as possible, as blatant as possible. And generally, I, have an unfiltered way of speaking. So definitely, I'll give you each and every situation, whatever is happening around, or probably I'll pick up instances from my life and also pick up instances from my friend's life or the observations that I have seen so far. And so there's a disclaimer. So you may or may not watch with someone or your partner, but I would definitely want all of you to watch this video and give me your inputs. So this video is definitely going to be a little longer. So you need to be a little patient with me. And whatever floats your boat, a cup of coffee or tea or mug of beer or a glass of wine, get started. So people who are actually new to my channel, I would like to tell them that I have had created, videos on relationships earlier. You could go to my playlist and you could see that I have created videos on relationships. I have created videos on casual relationships. I have created videos on Tinder. I've created video on relationships, relationship changes during this corona times. So you could have a look at those videos. You might feel that can be an eye opener to you, or you could relate to it. So if you want to watch relationships videos, in that case you can go through that, or I would like to link it up in the description box. So let's talk about today's modern relationships, because the question is the modern day relationships are very, very failing. Why are the modern day relationships failing? And especially I have got requests from people who are undergoing some kind of mental trauma, or they are in kind of some kind of mental stress, or the mental health is being affected, greatly affected because of relationships. So I thought that yes, definitely this is a real calling, and I should try creating one more a very candid video on relationships, on modern day relationships. So to begin with, I would like to state that as human beings, we have three major aspects of our lives, which are health, career, and relationships. And relationships actually, it is something that which cannot be taken for granted, and if it is ignored, then it takes a toll on other two things as well. So it is a very, very big, much bigger aspect than what we think. So if we talk about relationships, yes, relationships bring a lot of comfort, a lot of pleasure in our lives, and they try to actually enhance our existence, or they make a life worth living. So relationships are very, very important. But the problem today is, if we talk about today's generation, today's generation, or I would say the modern day relationships, what we have been observing is that relationship has become very, very body based, or it has become very, very, I would say, mechanized. It's very fragile. And I don't know, if we talk about the animal world, we are definitely not the most powerful beings on earth when it comes to physical prowess. We are definitely not the most beautiful ones also on earth. So what makes us stand apart, or what makes us different, is this, our intelligence. Okay, but then we don't understand that when it comes to relationships, why do we make it body based? Why is our intelligence hijacked? What happens to our other dimensions? Other dimensions, I'm talking about our consciousness, I'm talking about our emotions. Because जानवरों में और इंसानों में फर्क एक ही चीज का है, वो है विवेक, एंड दैट इज डाइंग. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट जानवर एंड इंसान ऑल्सो, ओके, यहाँ पे भी मैं आपको आपकी एक तुलना दे सकती हूँ, एक उपमा दे सकती हूँ. सपोज यू हैव अ पेट डॉग, इवन इफ यू हैव अ पेट डॉग एंड यू कम होम, यू नो, कम होम आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम, योर पेट डॉग स्टिल कम्स टू यू, ओके, इट हग्स यू, इट लिक्स यू, एंड इट शोज इट्स इमोशंस, ठीक है. And every day it needs you, right? Even though you give it little time, less time or no time, but you know that it is always there for you. And that doggy is going to be faithful to you, okay? But it is not the case with most of our partners, right? It is not the case. So you know, we have heard, like, you know, talks about dogs and bitches, and in the very bad context, okay. So friends, when I have to cite an example of a beautiful relationship, I gave you an example of a pet dog. We are talking about our pets, okay. And generally we have heard people referring to their boyfriends and girlfriends as stray dogs and bitches. Why is it so? So what is wrong with today's generation? So why is this happening? Why is there so much cheating? Why is there so much disloyalty, or I would say dishonesty? And all of us, most of us have experienced it. I have experienced it. I'm sure you have also experienced it. And we feel bad about it. We get into depression, and yes, but hardly nobody talks about it. So I don't know, like, what is wrong with our society, and people who are actually, it is as per a survey, people who cheat are definitely not very intelligent people. They lack that sexual confidence, and they are sexually disempowered. They are actually disillusioned. So for people who are actually very quick to enter into a relationship in a jiffy, so for these kind of people, relationships don't require much investment emotionally or intellectually. For them, relationships are just like fun, okay, or they are into relationships just for instant gratification. And of course, they have a very disruptive mentality or very destructive sexuality. I can't talk about this. So definitely they are not the normal people. And such people are, you know, they probably, for them, like, they are more into casual sex and all. But these people keep forgetting that casual sex can also lead to casualty. Now, if I talk about casual sex, I don't say that it is inappropriate, or it is, it is a big taboo in society. But my question is, please make sure that you're clear about it. Please keep your partner also, don't keep them guessing about it. Because, you know, what happens, I've seen with most of the girls, especially I'm talking about girls, so there is a disconnect between the boys and girls, and also at times boys also get disillusioned. They feel that if they enter into a relationship, that is going to give them a beautiful future or something. So, but actually it doesn't. Well, there are so many terms which are associated with today's modern day relationships, जो शायद पहले नहीं होते थे, लेकिन वो आजकल होते हैं. अगर हम बात करें तो friends with benefits, अगर हम बात करें तो कैजुअल रिलेशनशिप्स, अगर हम बात करें तो नो स्ट्रिंग्स अटैच्ड, अगर हम बात करें तो ओपन रिलेशनशिप्स, अगर हम बात करें तो पॉलीगैमस रिलेशनशिप्स, ओ माय गॉड, मतलब मेरी उंगलियां कम पड़ जाएंगी अगर मैं गिनती रहूं तो. तो ये सारी चीज़ें क्यों हो रही है, ये सारी चीज़ें क्या पहले होती थी? हैव वी ऑब्जर्व दिस थिंग्स लाइक जब हम छोटे थे, या फिर हमने कभी हमारे प्रीवियस जनरेशन्स को देखे हैं इस तरह करते हुए जो कि आजकल के जनरेशन वाले कर रहे हैं एकदम खुल्लम खुला? इज़ इट गुड, इज इट अप्रोप्रिएट? इफ़ आई टॉक अबाउट कैजुअल रिलेशनशिप्स और एनी काइंड ऑफ रिलेशनशिप्स फॉर दैट मैटर, so the problem here is when two people meet or two people get into a relationship, so you know they have different way of viewing the relationship, or probably they are on different planes altogether. You know, probably the girl is on an emotional note and the guy is not, he's on a physical note or whatever, or it can be either way also. I'm not blaming the boys every time. ओके, ऐसा नहीं है कि लड़कियां चीट नहीं करती है, लड़कियां भी चीट करती है, लेकिन व्हेन इट कम्स टू चीटिंग बॉयज आउटनंबर वुमेन, एंड आई अग्री टू दिस. आई होप यू वुड आल्सो अग्री टू दिस. तो मैंने ऐसा देखा है, इवन लाइक चीटिंग में भी, मतलब देखा तो है मैंने अ बॉय डेटिंग साइमल्टेनियसली 10 गर्ल्स, अ गर्ल डेटिंग साइमल्टेनियसली 20 बॉयज. सो ये आज का नॉर्म है और इसको काफ़ी कूल मानते हैं बहुत सारे लोग. तो यू नो, देखा हुआ है तो ऑब्वियसली. बट द क्वेश्चन इज व्हेन टू पीपल आर इन अ रिलेशनशिप विद डिफरेंट माइंडसेट्स, फिर क्या होता है? देन देयर इज अ बिग डिस्कनेक्ट, देन देयर इज अ बिग यू नो डिस्ट्रक्शन. तो एक बहुत ही बुरी अवस्था आती है रिलेशनशिप में. इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड द टॉक्सिसिटी ऑफ एनी रिलेशनशिप, यू नो, बिफोर इट डैमेजेस यू नो योर लाइफ. So I would like to narrate because I was in a toxic relationship with my ex-partner, and he was into substance abuse, he was into alcohol, he was a big time alcoholic, and you know, I had a hell, I have seen hell with him. So uske baad mujhe nikalne mein bahut time laga, but finally I'm relieved, and bahut struggle hua, बहुत तकलीफ हुई, लेकिन फाइन. एंड आई वॉज इन टू अ नर्वस ब्रेक डाउन ऑल्सो बिकॉज इट वॉज अ वेरी बिग, इट वॉज फॉर अ यू नो गुड पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. तो एंड वी शेयर्ड अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल रिलेशनशिप, बट इनिशियली इट स्टार्टेड वेल, बट उसके बाद इट बिकेम वेरी वेरी रफ. सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड द टॉक्सिसिटी ऑफ द रिलेशनशिप, एंड सो दैट यू कैन सेल थ्रू. और जैसे कि मैं बात कर रही थी कि यू नो, दो लोग आते हैं रिलेशनशिप में, लेकिन दो लोग यू नो, क्या होता है कि दे आर ऑन अ डिफरेंट यू नो प्लेन ऑल टुगेदर, ठीक है, दे हैव अ डिफरेंट माइंड सेट ऑल टुगेदर. सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू रेक्टिफाई ऑल्सो. सो इफ आई हैव टेकन द परमिशन ऑफ माई फ्रेंड्स एंड आई कैन गिव देयर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑल्सो. सो आई हैव अ फ्रेंड, हर नेम इज से कामिनी, एंड शी इज़ इन लव विद अ गाय हु इज़ अराउंड 7 to 8 ईयर्स यंगर टू हर, ठीक है. एंड कामिनी इज गेटिंग यू नो, कामिनी इज गेटिंग इन टू अ डिवोर्स, एंड सो इज ही, एंड दे मेट प्रोफेशनली समवेयर, एंड दे आर वेरी गुड फ्रेंड्स, एंड दे आर एक्चुअली मोर देन फ्रेंड्स. सो यू कैन से कि दे आर वेरी क्लोज, दे आर वेरी इंटीमेट यू नो, इमोशनली एज वेल एज फिजिकली. बट कामिनी इज एक्चुअली, she is very much scared of confessing her love for him, or you know, or confessing you know her emotions of getting married to him, theek hai. To wo bolti rehti hai that you know, we are the best of friends, okay, we hum sab kuch saath mein karte hain, we drink together, we dance together, we laugh together, and I would love to have him as my partner, as my life partner. But she is not sure about his feelings. When I ask her to talk about you know, or to confess to him her feelings, ki kya hai, because ultimately he's also getting divorced and you're also getting divorced, and both of you can have a beautiful life together. Now she confronted me saying that ki wo usse umar mein chota hai, pata nahi wo usse accept karega ya nahi karega. So she has her own inhibitions, she has her own doubts, own fear, which I find it very very irrelevant. And she feels ki aisa hi chalta raha, kya pata कल यू नो वो राजी हो जाए, उसको ही फील हो कि वो दोनों साथ रह सकते हैं. So my question to her is, yes, there is no kal. You need to be vocal. ठीक है, तो कल से कुछ नहीं होता. She is already in love with this guy and she is not sure of his feelings. तो this is the time, this is the high time that she should talk about it and she should say कि अगर you know if he feels the same for her then they can be together or they can be because it's a high time now. She has to take a decision. So पर ऐसा नहीं है एंड अनफॉर्चुनेटली ऐसी बहुत लड़कियां सोचती हैं. तो शी इज़ अ गुड फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन, शी इज़ अ वेरी गुड फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन एंड आई वुड लव टू सी हर सेटल्ड बट देन आई डोंट नो इफ शी हैज़ चोजन द राइट गाय और नॉट, दैट आई डोंट नॉट नो. आई एज अ फ्रेंड आई वुड ऑलवेज एडवाइज कि तुम उससे डायरेक्ट फेस टू फेस बात करो, बट शी फील्स दैट यू नो कि वो उसने सब कुछ फ्यूचर पे छोड़ दिया है. तो माई क्वेश्चन इज, यू कांट लिव इन अनसर्टनटी, राइट? मुझे नहीं पता अनसर्टनिटी में कैसे जी जाती है. अगर फॉर एग्जांपल मैं अपनी बात कहूँ तो इफ़ आई हैव टू ट्रैवल समवेयर, ठीक है, जब तक मेरा टिकट नहीं आता मेरी पैकिंग नहीं होती है मेरे कपड़ों की, बिकॉज आई कैन वर्क अंडर स्ट्रेस बट आई कैनॉट वर्क इन अनसर्टनिटी. जब तक मुझे मेरा टिकट नहीं मिल रहा, अगर इवन इफ आई एम ट्रैवलिंग टू नाइट और आई एम ट्रैवलिंग टुमारो ऑल्सो, आई नीड टू हैव माई टिकट एटलीस्ट, मतलब कम से कम मुझे यू नो 12 घंटा या 24 घंटा पहले मुझे मेरे टिकट चाहिए, तब जाके यू नो आई विल डू माई पैकिंग. आई कांट लिव इन अनसर्टनिटी, आई कैन वर्क अंडर स्ट्रेस, ठीक है. तो वो चीज़ है. तो बट आई थिंक दिस इज नॉट द सेम विथ लॉट ऑफ पीपल बिकॉज दे आर अंडर इम्प्रेशन कि कल क्या पता कुछ मैजिक हो जाए, इसका मन बदल जाए और ये मुझे खुद प्रपोज कर ले. सो ये चीज़ है. And so this puts us, this makes me feel that we girls, hum log kitna, we are so, you know, low in self-esteem that we can't even talk to a guy. And aur aisa kyun hai? I mean, matlab, frankly speaking, mere saath to aisa nahi hai, but I'm really thoughtful of her. Ki generally, aisa kyun karti hai ladkiya? Why are they scared to approach a guy? जिसके साथ वो ऑलरेडी इतने फ्री है और ऑलरेडी इतने फ्रैंक है, क्यों ऐसा क्यों करते हैं? सो दिस अगेन ब्रिंग्स लॉट ऑफ डिस्कम्फर्ट, दिस अगेन ब्रिंग्स लॉट ऑफ डिस्कनेक्ट इन रिलेशनशिप्स, बिकॉज इफ यू डू नॉट नो योर पार्टनर्स थॉट प्रोसेस देर इज अ बिग डिस्कनेक्ट. एंड जनरली यू हैव ट्रस्ट इशूज विद पीपल हु आर वेरी मच गार्डेड, जिनके बारे में आपको कुछ पता ही नहीं चल रहा हो कि उनके मन में क्या चल रहा है. सो इट इज देर इज समथिंग दैट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड वी नीड टू स्ट्रेटन इट आउट. And this would be my request to most of the girls who are under this kind of situation, or the guys probably they are also facing this kind of situation. So, ये मेरा आपसे request रहेगा. So, guys, if this is the similar case with you, you need to buck up and you need to be very, very careful and very, very aware. Where are we heading to? बिकॉज अगर आप एक्सीलेटर दबा देते हैं जहाँ पे ब्रेक्स लगाने चाहिए तो ऑब्वियसली देयर वुड बी एक्सीडेंट्स एंड देयर वुड बी टेरिबल टेरिबल हार्ट ब्रेक्स. सो कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट, आई वुड से द नेक्स्ट केस टॉक्स अबाउट अ वेरी गुड एक्वेंटेंस ऑफ माइन एंड शी लिव्स इन दिस विसिनिटी एंड हर नेम इज प्रियंका. एंड नाउ दिस गर्ल टोल्ड मी वंस दैट यार शी इज़ बीन डेटिंग अ गाय फॉर इयर्स एंड He happens to be her boyfriend and she loves him like anything. He is also madly in love with her. But then somehow they are not destined to get married. When I asked why, so to my amazement, she replied ki, you know, because he's from a higher caste and I'm from a lower caste. Wo Brahmin hai, main non-Brahmin hoon. So then I said, so what? Then she said to me ki, nahin, Brahmins jo hai, wo non-Brahmin se shaadi kahan karte hai. Maine kaha ki, achha. So then I gave her my example, घर का example ही दे दिया मैंने. You know what? My dad is a Brahmin and my mother was from a non-Brahmin community. I'm उनका product हूँ मैं और मेरी ऐसी बिल्कुल सोच नहीं है, ठीक है. So and मेरी भी ऐसी कोई सोच नहीं है that I have to marry a a Brahmin family or something or I'm seeking a Brahmin guy. So ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है. So I was really taken aback. By her words, कि लोगों की सोच ऐसी है, मुझे बिल्कुल समझ में नहीं आता. when it comes to marriages, people have so many reservations. Yes, people are very much particular about caste, about community, about the culture, about the looks, about the the status of the family, about even if it's a love marriage, people are concerned about a lot of things. Okay, about the education, about everything and anything under the sun. Okay, so even ki uske rishtedar kaise hain, unka reputation kaisa hai, ye bhi sab dekhte hain. And when it comes to relationships, nothing matters. I feel nothing matters these days, hai na. Samne wale ke looks don't matter. Samne wale ka I would say uska education, uska intelligence, everything is sideline. Nothing matters. The person's the tastes, preferences, nothing matters to you. The caste, community, of course, ye sab matter hi nahi karta. And of course, jahan pe status ki baat aati hai, to marital status ki baat aati hai, to aapka to kya hum aapka bhi apna bhi bhool jaye, hai na? To aisa kyun hai? Matlab ye hum yahi soch kar relationships mein utarte hain ki that our needs are very shallow, very very shallow, or ya fir these are very physical need based relationships ki इनकी जो है ये इनका ग्रोथ ही पॉसिबल नहीं है, या फिर दिमाग में लोगों का यही रहता है कि टू गेट इनटू टू हैव एज मेनी पार्टनर्स एज पॉसिबल. बिकॉज आई हैव नोन पीपल हु हैव पर्सनली कन्फेस्ड दैट दे हैव हैड सो मेनी पार्टनर्स, दे हैव बीन डेटिंग सो मेनी पीपल एट द सेम टाइम एंड दे हैव हैड सो मेनी पार्टनर्स इन देयर लाइफ टाइम, 10 किसी के, 20, 30, 40, 50 प्लस ऐसे लोगों ने कन्फेस किए हैं. तो आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट सेक्सुअल पार्टनर्स, तो आप समझ सकते हो. तो अगर ऐसा सिचुएशन है, ऐसी स्थिति रही, तो फ्यूचर, आई डोंट नो व्हाट डज द फ्यूचर होल्ड फॉर अस. बिकॉज मैं आपको कुछ बना के नहीं बोल रही हूँ, मैं आपको बिल्कुल वही चीज़ें बोल रही हूँ जो मैंने खुद ऑब्जर्व किए और अपने कानों से सुने हैं. एंड आई डोंट नो व्हाई पीपल ब्रैग अबाउट saying such things, and unko kya maza aata hai ye sab karne mein. I mean, why are people getting turned into sexual supernova? It is just not it is just insane. I would say it's just insane. So casual dating is very very frequent, and I would say it is it's a norm of the society today. And because sex has become a part of the courtship period, and rather than sex becoming a result of the courtship period, where both the people are well acquainted with each other, they have known each other for a good time, and they have grown respect for each other. There's a lot of love and respect in the relationship. There's a lot of care and concern and space in relationship, and then only such relationships can actually mature. Otherwise, there is no hope if we talk about just dating, casual dating, and just dating recklessly. Because casual dating is just like mindless eating. Okay, so if there is a lot of junk food, a lot of fast food, and you are having things in a jiffy, of course that is going to spoil your system. So these are the things that I wanted to share with you, because it's very important to know the toxicity of the relationships. And there are a lot of signs where you can see the toxicity of a relationship or unhealthy love. It could be jealousy, it could be infatuation, it could be possessiveness, it could be emotional outbursts, or getting into emotional fits, and then also manipulation and also control freak. So I have seen people who would say that my partner is very possessive, but at the same time the partner is not committed. So how is possessiveness going to help without getting committed? Okay, so I am not committed to you, but I'm possessive of you. So what a funny situation. So for people who are actually very very eager to get into relationships just for fun or probably instant gratification, so for them my message would be, look, I can't get more clearer than this. Don't get into a relationship just for orgasms, because I have come across such people, and especially men who brag about it. Oh, I get lucky with every woman I meet. Oh, I get lucky with lot of girls, क्या मजा आता है यार, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ यू नो इमेज आर यू पोर्ट्रेइंग. ठीक है, सो इट इज रियली सैड. नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी सैड सिचुएशन ऑफ द सोसाइटी एंड इट रियली हर्ट्स. एंड आपको खुद बुरा लगता है, जैसे हम ह्यूमन बींग्स तो है लेकिन अल्टीमेटली शायद वो सारी चीज़ें वो सारे तक में लग जाएंगे जो मैंने अभी यू नो वीडियो के शुरुआत में कही थी. इफ थिंग्स गो ऑन लाइक दिस, दिस विल लीड टू डिस्ट्रक्शन. आई मीन इट्स वेरी वेरी बैड एंड दिस इज व्हाई देयर लॉट ऑफ डिसकनेक्ट इन रिलेशनशिप्स. देयर लॉट ऑफ हार्ट ब्रेक्स because vulnerability is nowhere in the relationship, and vulnerability is very very important aspect or very it's a great thing for intimacy. When I'm talking about intimacy, of course I'm talking about emotional intimacy, because intimacy by default is you know it means emotional. So relationship mein emotional intimacy aane se pehle hi log yahan pe physically intimate ho jate hain. And uske baad kya hota hai, uske baad like after you have the dessert, I mean you are in no mood having the meal. तो यही चीज़ होता है and यही mistakes करती हैं कुछ लड़कियाँ, you know most लड़कियाँ और कुछ लड़के. So I feel that there has to be a check and for people who, for whom sanctity is attached to relationships, I mean physical relationships, if sanctity dies it becomes vulgarity. So let's not make relationships vulgar, let's make it beautiful. And there has to be reciprocation of feelings. Okay, so there has to be reciprocation of feelings. It could be casual, it could be serious, but there has to be proper communication. It just cannot be just consensual. It has to be transparent also. So please try to be, please try to reciprocate your feelings and don't just get into a relationships. Don't fake a relationship. Don't get into an abusive relationship. Things are getting very very nasty, and especially to deal with these, especially a person like me who's demisexual, who just can't be with somebody unless there is a proper emotional connection, because I can't be with somebody who doesn't stimulate me intellectually or emotionally. So I find it very very difficult. And and I'm proud to say that yes, monogamy is my choice. You could be critical, you could be against it, or you may leave it or like it. So that's your choice. So but that is something that I would always like to profess, because that is how human beings should be. Okay, human beings are not animals. Human beings are social animals, and that's why marriages were made. And I would say that last but not the least, that you should put your foot forward. You should be sure of your relationship, what kind of relationship you are entering into, and what does it offer you, and how is it going to construct you, or is it going to be destructive to you, your career, your family. So please keep a check. And it is very very important that you need to have your own world also outside your relationships. I'm talking about your romantic relationships. You need to create a relationship or a beautiful bonding with yourself. That's very important, with your family, with your siblings, your work, your colleagues, your creativity, your hobbies. Don't cheat, but you need to have a life of your own as well outside your relationship. Because if you put everything in your relationship, if that relationship breaks, it breaks you like anything. And that is something that I have already witnessed. That is something which I have gone through, and it was difficult, and I have sailed across. So that would be my advice to you all. And I hope you like this video. I have tried my best to be as honest as possible. And with full honesty, I have given you all the examples. And so the purpose of creating this video is not about teaching you morality. It is talking about living life with responsibility and sensibility. So with this note, I would leave you here, and please make sure to tell me that how did you find this video. And if you want such videos in future on relationships, you could write it to me, and I would be more than happy to create or make videos for you. I don't shy away from creating videos like this. it was just, you know, I had to collect some facts and I was working on it, and I was also occupied with some other professional commitments. But of course, you are my subscribers, you are my viewers, and I love you all. So anything for you. And I would love bringing you, you know, interesting and you know, relevant topics which you can relate to. So my request to you would be to share this video as much as possible, because I feel a lot of people could connect to it. They would find it relevant and they also might find it helpful. So mere liye kaam kijiye, is video ko aap share kijiye. Make sure you give it a like, a big thumbs up, and zyada se zyada share kare, zyada se zyada you know, इसे अपने दोस्तों को दिखाए. और इफ यू आर लाइक अ फर्स्ट टाइमर ऑन माय चैनल, प्लीज मेक श्योर दैट यू आल्सो सब्सक्राइब यू नो माय टू माय चैनल एंड हिट द बेल बटन एज वेल, सो दैट यू गेट ऑल द अपडेट्स एंड नोटिफिकेशंस एवरी टाइम आई अपलोड अ न्यू वीडियो. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे फ्रेंड्स, एंड आई होप टू सी यू अगेन, एंड यू कुड फॉलो मी ऑन इंस्टा. एंड एक और चीज़ मैं आप लोगों को बताना चाहूँगी कि मैंने अपने कुछ ऑनलाइन क्लासेस शुरू किए हैं और अभी यू नो काफ़ी लोग एनरोल हो चुके हैं. तो अगर आपको कुछ करना है तो एवरीथिंग इज़ मेंशन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स एंड ऑल्सो मेरे अबाउट सेक्शन में आप जाके देख सकते हैं. सो मैंने शुरू कर दिए हैं. इफ़ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन एनरोल, सो लेट मी नो एंड टेक योर फ्रेंड्स.